Assalamu alaikum, this is Faiz Mahmood with another lecture of Correct Use of English. This is correct lecture 17 of this series. Today we will learn the use of preposition and the use of different words, which if we do not use correctly in the sentence, the meaning will quite opposite of the meaning which we are taking from these sentences. He is known all over the world. The correct sentence is, he is known all the world over. First thing is, you use all the, and you use world over, not over the world. Something is not over the world. Something is world over. Something is popular, the world over, not over the world. You are not putting something over the world. Like you are putting something over your head. Here is a chair to sit. If you do not use the preposition with sit, the meaning of the sentence would not be complete. Similarly, this is a pen to write with. If you do not use this with write, its meaning will not be clear as you are taking from it. Here is a cup to drink with, similarly. These are the expression. If you do not use preposition with them, their meanings will become quite opposite to what you are saying. Meaning would not be complete. Now, here's a sentence which you people may be thinking right, but grammatically it is wrong. You may use, he lives in New York. You may use, he lives in Lahore. You may use, he lives in Riyadh. You may use, he lives in Birmingham. But with London, always you will use at, he lives at London. For small places, we use in. For bigger places, we use at. For in. For small places, at. For bigger places, in. But for London, we use at. He lives at New York in United States. This is correct. He lives at Lahore in Pakistan, right. He lives at I-9 in Islamabad, correct. But he lives at London. This is the right expression. With London, you will always use at, not in. This is another we use often. This sentence you people might have listened. This is a check for HBL. Never. Check is always on the bank, not for the bank. This is a check for on HBL. She always sighs. Incomplete. Without preposition, this is not giving the meaning which you are taking from the sentence. She always sighs with her brother. I beg to differ from you in this matter. You use the expression differ from when you differ from some argument, something. When you differ with person, you use I beg to differ with you in this matter. With person, you will use with things or arguments, you will use from. He entered in the room. When there's a motion, you will use the expression into. He jumped into the river. He entered into the room. And when someone is sitting in a closed place or someone is sitting somewhere, you may use in. When you are watching motion in that movement, you are watching movement, you will use entered into. Similarly, he jumped not in the river, but into the river. There is a motion. Into shows motion. And you want to express motion, you will use into. And when there is no motion, you will use in. This is all for today's lecture. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. Thank you very much for watching this. Allah Hafiz.